Leia here from leiaforsci.com, and in this video, we're going to look at a quick introduction to alcohol, including an overview and structure, so that we can move on to physical properties, acids, bases, and of course reactions in the remainder of this series. You can find the alcohol series along with the practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website, leiaforsci.com/alcohol. Alcohols are very important in organic chemistry. Alcohols can participate in many reactions, either when you're creating an alcohol, like you learned in substitution, when you're using an alcohol to create something else, or as an in-between in longer multi-step synthesis and reactions. Let's backtrack to the basics. When you hear alcohol, you should immediately think of an oxygen bound to a hydrogen. This is the alcohol functional group. Just oxygen bound to a hydrogen. For example, if you see a molecule that has an OH on a carbon, but that same carbon also has a carbonyl, that's not an alcohol. This is a carboxylic acid which you should have studied when you looked at functional groups. Methanol is the smallest alcohol, and it has a CH3 bound to an oxygen bound to a hydrogen. This is the simple Lewis structure, so we can see all the bonds and atoms. The oxygen atom has four groups attached to it. We have the hydrogen, the methyl group, and two lone pairs. Four groups means that it's sp3 hybridized. With a bond angle of approximately 109.5, but it's slightly smaller. That's because if we look at this alcohol as a 3D structure, we'll have the two lone pairs in the plane of the page. We'll show the CH3 coming out of the page and the hydrogen going into the page. The electron density is greater at the lone pairs compared to the two electrons that make up a bond between oxygen-carbon or oxygen-hydrogen, and that means these electrons are bulging out, pushing slightly on the carbon and hydrogen, bringing them closer together for a bond angle that is slightly less than 109.5. Oxygen is a highly electronegative atom, and when bound to hydrogen, which is less electronegative, you're going to have an unequal sharing of electrons in that covalent bond, making it a polar covalent bond where the hydrogen has the positive end and oxygen negative. You can represent this with a delta negative at the oxygen, delta positive at the hydrogen. This will be very important when we look at things like hydrogen bonding, solubility, and boiling point in the physical properties video. Alcohols can be classified as primary, secondary, or tertiary, depending on what is attached to the alpha carbon or the carbon holding the alcohol. Methanol does not have anything attached to the carbon, so it doesn't fit this classification. For the rest, we'll use the pencil trick, which I teach in the tutorial link below. The alcohol on ethanol sits on a carbon that has just one bond coming out of it, making it a primary alcohol. In ethanol, the oxygen sits on a carbon with two bonds to carbon, making it a secondary alcohol. And in tert-butyl alcohol, the carbon is bound to one, two, three carbon atoms, making it a tertiary alcohol. Many students get scared when a ring is brought into the picture, so let's see the same thing. The alcohol sits on a primary carbon, once again giving us a primary alcohol. This alcohol sits on a carbon with two bonds to carbon, making it a secondary alcohol. And finally, the alcohol sits on a carbon bound to three carbon atoms, making it a tertiary alcohol. You should also recognize a molecule that has an alcohol sitting on the very same carbon as a pi bond. This is both an alkene and an alcohol, which we call the enol, and you should recognize this from your alkyne reactions. And of course, you'll see many more in your advanced orgo 2 reactions. One more alcohol that's really important to recognize is phenol. When you have an OH sitting directly on a benzene ring, this is called a phenol, not to be confused with phenol, which is benzene as a substituent on a carbon atom. When it comes to naming alcohols, you simply drop the E at the end of the name and add OL for the ol in alcohol. This is discussed in detail in the alcohol naming video link below, but let's look at a few. We've already seen methanol. It gets the name meth from having one carbon, ane from just being an alkane. Then we drop the E, add an OL for methanol. Ethanol has two carbons, giving us a first name of eth, last name of ane, add the OL, and we get ethanol. We don't need a number one because it's self-understood as being the carbon holding the OH. For this molecule, we have three carbon atoms for a first name of prop, no double bonds for a last name of ane, an OL on carbon 2 for 2O, bring the 2 out to the front for 2 propane, drop the E, all, for 2 propanol. What about this one? What do we have? Two carbons for a first name of F, only single bonds, last name of ane, two alcohols on carbons 1 and 2, so we specify 1, 2, and specify that it's a diol. Bring the numbers out to the front, and that gives us 1, 2 ethane diol. The reason we don't drop the E is because we have D, which is a consonant following the vowel. We only drop the E when it would have been a vowel following another vowel, O following E. And what about this one? We have three carbons for a first name of prop, only single bonds in the chain for a last name of ane, alcohols on carbon 1, 2, and 3, giving us a triol. Bring the numbers out to the front, giving us 1, 2, 3, propane triol. The reason I chose these molecules is you should recognize them beyond their IUPAC names. Methanol is wood alcohol. You'll see this a lot in reactions. Ethanol is grain alcohol or drinking alcohol. You'll also see this as a common solvent in reactions. 2-propanol or isopropyl alcohol, or isopropanol, which is your standard rubbing alcohol. 1,2-ethanediol is ethylene glycol, and this is a carbonyl protecting group that you'll see very soon. And finally, 1,2,3-propanetriol is also glycerol. This is the backbone that you use for fatty acid formation. Be sure to join me in the next video where we look at physical properties of alcohol, including hydrogen bonding, solubility, and boiling point. You can find this entire series along with the alcohol practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website, leahforsci.com/alcohol.